Hey guys, Nocturne here. Good to see all of you. Sorry about not, like, cycling through music, but I was folding clothes. Be amazed how many clothes you accumulate, considering I usually only wear a pair of shorts. Anyway, as you can see, we're playing Gremlins 2, the new batch. This is the only game that came out on the NES that was based on the Gremlins franchise. And it's horror adjacent. And it's actually a really good game, so I figured I'd play it today and see how far I get. And like I said... Oh yeah, he was in Multiverses. That was a Warner Brothers property. I never played Multiverses myself. Alright, you're sick of that song by now, so let's move on. Oh, it was one of those, huh? Those are my favorites. There's Gizmo. There's Zach Galligan as Billy Peltzer in his only appearance. Okay. So, before we start... Oh yeah, I love Gremlins 2 a lot. I actually saw it first because I was born in 1983, so I was born... after the first Gremlins actually came out, so I didn't see it when I was little. I ended up seeing Gremlins 2 first. Same thing with Ghostbusters 2. I ended up seeing that first before I saw the original. So those are the only two cases of me seeing a sequel to a movie before I saw the original because of when I was born. So, as you can see, we got no lives, we got 3 health, we got 1 balloon, and we got no crystal. And we have a tomato. Or a tomato, if you will. Yeah, they are, but I really like Gremlins 2, because Joe Dante just basically did whatever the hell he wanted, and I respect that when a director does that. Okay, so you can jump. And you can throw tomato. And there are pits everywhere in this friggin' game. So as you can see, getting hit doesn't get rid of a heart right away. It takes 2 hits. So we have 6 hit points before the game is over. Yes. Did that respawn everything? No good. Yes. So, we get crystal balls here. That's our currency because there are shops. In fact, there should be one right up here. Indeed. There's the old Chinese man who owns Gizmo. So, let's see what we got. We got this, which refills our health. We've got a balloon, which if we fall down a pit and have a balloon, it'll let us float around for a little bit and get past the trap. Otherwise, we get set back to the beginning of the pit. And an extra life. We are definitely going to buy the hell out of these. Because otherwise, after the 6 hits, it's game over. Whoops. See, that's what the balloon does. That other item I grabbed was a light bulb, and even though gremlins don't like bright light, grabbing a light bulb will flash the screen and kill all the enemies on screen. There's a pogo stick, makes you invincible. for an incredibly short period of time. And there we go. That's the first level. Yay! So as you saw, the game was made by Sunsoft. So you can expect some bitchin' tunes throughout the entire thing, because Sunsoft never missed when it came to game music. Anything over here? A rat! That's it. And you see it's starting already, with spikes in the ground and pits, and it's only gonna get more worse and insane from here. Oh, which one was it? I'm curious. Oh, I'm about to lose that life I bought. Oh, you have to go through all that. Yep, there we go. Good thing I got that extra life. Paying homage by blatantly ripping a song off. Well, I remember the original version of the game Eversion. The freeware used the song from the game Cocorone. Oh yeah, this game is insane with how difficult it gets. Thank you. Unfortunately, you can only use the store once. That kind of sucks, but you know, that's how it goes. Nope, don't go that way. Oh, perfect. Don't bat. Nope, never mind. Forget it. Aha! We have a new weapon. But we have a cutscene. Gizmo gets wet, and he births the other four Mogwais. Look at that pixel art. Fucking amazing. Just shove his ass into the vents. Yeah, I know. Isn't the pixel art in this game great? Look at that face. Look at that Gizmo face. So now, as you see, we have a new weapon. We have a matchstick now. Can't kill those things. Damn it. Yeah, those things you need to watch out for, because they dash right at you and try to blow up. Nope, thought there was a door over there, but there's not. I tricked myself. Now here we go. Here's where we're starting the shit already. So we got this electric gate that hurts you. We got these spike balls that hurt you, and there's a pit in between the two of them. Damn it. I hit the jump button, but it didn't happen. That's it. Good thing I had that extra life saved up. Thank you. So, no extra life here, but we can get a power up for our item. Now we have a triple shot. Hey, I saw you over there. Kind of like how it is in Monster Party, the same enemies will drop the same power-ups every time you play through the game. So like that one enemy that had the pogo stick, it'll always have a pogo stick when I kill it. Okay, quick confession. When I was a kid and I used to rent this game, this is about as far as I would get before I would just keep gaming over and over again. So the game would be fun for me, but very brief because this is as far as I could get. And you'll see why, because stuff just gets out of control in a hurry. This guy, who you can't really hit. Yes, he sure did. All the time. I can't even really... This is usually where I would get, corralled. No, they didn't. I'm not even hitting the guy. Jesus. Yay! Jeez, alright, fine. I can't jump two squares, so that's too far. Alright. Two. One, two, three, four. Okay. It's minimal health loss. Okay. I could really use a door right now. No thank you, sir. No thank you, sir. Come here. Come here. so hard to do a diagonal in this game. About what would happen. Oh, you're gonna use up the nose a little early with this. And see, I'm back to one crappy matchstick. I got no crystal balls. Yeah. Oh, so many old games were like that. And now I gotta get through this guy. And he just don't stop. Ugh. Alright. It's fine. We'll just float away. And I'm already back down to one heart. Although the yeah, don't think so, bitch. Come on. Come here, you. So difficult to do diagonals in this game. That was close. Yep, he's back. Alright. You bastards. I ain't stopping. I wonder if I can jump that. Let's see. Nope. I will take the hit, though. Didn't get as far as I wanted, but that's okay. Let's see. There we go. Just gotta turn that guy on and have him come over. Nope. Come on. I was gonna say, I know you're floating around here. Yeah, exactly. You only can power up each weapon once. Which is a good thing, like you said. Thank you. Okay. Oh, an extra life. Yeah, I'm getting that. Because I'm about to need it. Yep, good thing I got it. Oh, come on with this shit. Sure, whatever, fine. Okay. Yeah, they were coming for that Mogwai booty. Shut up. Just because it's true doesn't mean it needs to be said. That was dumb. But whatever. I'll just clear my way through here. Luckily, they can't seem to jump those gaps. Actually, let's try this instead. Haha! I made it somehow. Okay, this is where that fire-breathing one is again. I remember that. Okay, then. Don't jump for that one. Good to know. See how many people I can drive away with my shitty plane. Stay up here and avoid the skateboard guy. Oh, thanks for putting me on top of the spikes, too. Great. Nope. Jesus. Okay. Take a hit here. Oh, it looks like if I have a balloon, I don't take a hit when I fall down a pit. It's good to know. Seemed to me like it was a once-in-a-lifetime thing. There we go. That was easier. I don't know why I did that. No, I would never do that. If I did that, I'd have some, I'd have a lot more followers if I did that. But I refuse. Let's see. No, I'm going for the extra life. The extra life will always win out. Yeah. I ain't got time for that shit. Ugh, God. That's the worst. Or I can scream and make a wild hyperbole about how scary I am. Or how scared I am from the spooky JPEGs that jump at you. Fuck that shit. I am Markiplier. You gonna jump down or not? Definitely don't want kids watching me. Not with how many times I say the fuck word. Nope. Yeah, I saw you. Oh, thank God. Of course, now I gotta fight the boss. Thank you for the head pats. Good thing he has such a giant hitbox. And of course we know this is Mohawk Gremlin, the leader of the four that jumped out of Yzmo's body when he got wet. I almost did that no hit. Boy, anytime you want to die, go right ahead. Don't let me stop you. Oop, I got greedy. There we go. Now, I have a paperclip. So I'm far more dangerous. Look at that. Yes. Not so giant, though, after you actually get it. So let's take a little breather for a second. Oh yeah, I know. Trust me. I know all about that. So, this is the furthest I've gotten on my own without codes or anything like that. That's a new item. Oh, he's coming closer. I don't like that. Okay. Oh yeah, this looks good. Look at this insane garbage. Oh, thank you. Yes, please. Yeah, I noticed that too. Spreadshot. And a real spread shot, not like that stupid three-way thing the fire had us doing. I know, right? Well, this is quite a predicament. Oh, I can't touch the post, apparently. Well, yeah, I keep the paperclip, but I lost the spread shot. They can't take the paperclip away from you, then you'd have no weapons at all. And they're not that unfair. You get a free balloon, though. Yay! Nah, I gotta get that spread shot. I was on Netflix today, and I watched the Castlevania Nocturne series, the new Castlevania that came out, and I really liked it. That'll be my next article talking about it sometime this October. Aha! See how the simplest solution was the one that was hardest to grasp. That was a gremlin made out of food. Ooh, spooky graveyard. That was a wall. That was a wall, you stupid idiot. One of these days I'll actually dodge that. Yes, exactly. That's usually about how it goes. So much easier than whatever the hell I was trying to do. Do this intelligently this time. That's a wall. This is open. Whoop! No, no. Whoop! whatever. I'm ballooning, baby. Ah. The balloon saved the day. Unfortunately, it's about to get even more nightmarish. Like this, for example, with these conveyor belts that just dump you off into a pit. Yeah. Yep. Yeah, exactly. Alright, let's take a little break. Take a little 5-minute break. I'll be right back. Okay. So yeah, Castlevania Nocturne. It was really good. I enjoyed it. Of course, the only thing I had a problem with was, as was in the original Castlevania series, it starts to degenerate into everybody just saying fuck for every other word. And I know that sounds strange coming from me, but you know, it's supposed to be a period piece, you know? And it just sounds strange that I hear that word coming out of so many people. Okay. That was a lot easier. Yes. Thank you, balloon. And now we got moving platforms that are rolling right through hazards that you gotta jump over, too. Oh man, that extra life is really tempting. but I don't know if I want to go into the boss fight with only a single. Alright. I'll get the extra life. Oh? Ah! So what game was it? Huh. Never heard of it. Ah. Oh, this gremlin is too intelligent. He keeps dodging my attacks. I see. Ooh, boy. Just keep jumping. No! Get away! Oh, great. Thanks. Just in time for me to squander that life. Projectiles all over the goddamn place. And of course, they don't start me at the boss. They start me back here. This is how angry I am. Alright. Start throwing tornadoes out all over the place, buddy. Almost made it. Trying very hard not to cheat. Ah, I see. Well, I suppose then the music is valid.
Thank you.
Jump, Gizmo. Jesus. I only have 80. Music is very appropriate too. Like, I always seem to press the jump button like a millisecond too late. Good, I can afford the extra life this time. So that gives me a tiny bit of leeway. I know. It's annoying. Can't get me in here, bastards. Fuck the two of you. Alright. And with my extra life intact. Unfortunately, I'm still dead in one hit, so. Yeah, each stage would be a joke, but I mean, if you saved up enough crystal balls and grinded enough for that, don't you think you deserve it? There we go. Oof. Yow yowza. Oh, never mind, there's Billy Peltzer again. In the derelict part of this part of the clamp building, I guess. There we have this lunatic throwing fucking hats all over the place. Oh, I know. I know there's only 5 levels. There's a reason, though, there's a reason why I gave myself 4 hours. That's okay. If by some miracle I do end up beating the game early, I do have a backup plan for something to do. No, it's not Jaws. I was hitting somebody off screen. Please, a door somewhere. My kingdom for a door. Two paths to go by. Okay, this way looks like progress. What is this way? Let's try it. Well, I hope this is worth it. Oh, looks like it was a shortcut. Fine with me. This, however, is not fine. Oh well. That's fine. At least there's infinite continues. No! Yeah, fine. Let's pretend that didn't happen. Although, I would like someone to get a clip of that, of me totally dodging and weaving those top hats like a boss. Stop leaning my hands on my desk. They keep going numb. Excuse me. Okay. I'm gonna try going up. I wanna see if there's a door up here. Definitely buying this. Yes, a five-way spread. Don't mind if I do. I still have 3 hearts. Oh, just jump for it. Never mind. Just go. Right. Thank you. I'll put that on the Discord and my YouTube channel later. Now we're in the genetics laboratory. Nope. Oh well. It's fine. password, Vilb. God, I'm gonna miss that five-way spread. Yeah. Yep, exactly. Well, that's fine. I have the balloon. Well, that was fun. I'm so glad I used the balloon. Yeah, you'll be seeing a lot of that bullshit in level 5, where they'll have a long string of platforms and stuff, and if you fall down, they push you all the way back to the start if you didn't land on any solid ground. The boss of this level is a giant pain in the ass because there's spikes and shit all over the floor of his boss room. Spawning no tornadoes in my face, buddy. Thank you. Shit. I fell down the hole. Well, things are shaping up pretty bad for old Gizmo. Another conundrum. One of these ways might lead to a door. Well, I won't. I'll never know, I guess. Alright, let me get something to drink. Give me 1 second. Thank you. Speaking of Gizmo, is Howie Mandel still a thing? Like, does he still do stuff, or has he, like, hermetically sealed himself inside a glass dome because of his germophobia? Fire and a platform that way. And I see ground that way. And I really wish I would jump when I press the jump button. Ah, door's right over here. Oh, that's easy. Definitely gonna buy this. Nope, that's a dead end. Excuse me. This looks like a nightmare. I got clicked. You see, though, how rarely they sell extra lives in this game. Alright, nope, I'm not. I'm upset. We're starting that over. We're doing a do-over. I shouldn't be dying at that soon in the level. Yeah, exactly. Oh, okay. Actually, no, we can do it right now. Because luckily, there's no music on the pause menu in this game. So let's go here. Here. Up here. Whoops, too high. There we go. Alright, let's see what we get.
Bigfoot. Based on the national craze of monster trucks with wheels and suspension.
Remember there was a Bigfoot video game?
Over rows of cars and uncharted terrain. It's crunching, munching, crash and bash, off-road action that's guaranteed to be one of the most exciting video games ever.
Remember Bigfoot had a cartoon that was based off the video game?
Terrorforce of all. Think you can wipe out the world?
Hell yeah, Cabal.
Fools! They've got thugs, choppers, jet fighters. Go it alone or get help. But if you fail, you'll end up like me. Cabal, for your Nintendo.
Okay, there we go. Bigfoot and Cabal. The only thing I remember about Cabal is the little dance the guy does after he beats a level. I think that's probably what anybody remembers about Cabal. Well, no. Cabal is a lot different from Operation Wolf because Operation Wolf, you don't control your guy on screen. You just control a crosshair. I remember the arcade cabinet for Operation Wolf was just a gun, like the Terminator 2 arcade game. In fact, the Terminator 2 arcade game might have been a conversion kit for Operation Wolf. I don't know. I don't know if they were made by the same people or not. cling tightly to my balloon. Nope, I'm out of here. See ya. Alright, I got enough to get the upgrade. Push jump button. Jump no happen. Why jump no happen when I push jump button? Come on. Whatever. Fine, whatever. I'm gonna check something quick. Be back in a second. Oh, there's a sound test in the Japanese version, but not here. And I see level passwords, but those don't help. Oh well. Let's see. I can't get the power from Nintendo Power, because that wouldn't help, really. No, we're good. I'll keep trying. We'll do 10 more tries and then see where we are there. Oh, whoops. You didn't miss anything. Oopsie. Well, yes, I am a Twitch affiliate. Why do you ask? We'll be right back. Try that again. Have to break out my Game Genie code handbook. I'm really trying not to. Gizmo was no more. Drink. Funny thing is, if I die on the boss, I'm gonna have to do this level over again. There we go. This hitbox is very strange, I'm learning. whatever. I ain't doing this on one heart. That's for damn sure. That's about to start. So, I doubt I'm gonna make much progress, so. And remember, if you don't want to be bothered by ads, you could always subscribe. You could always subscribe. I can barely get through saying that with a straight face. Ha ha ha! Oh, good, I still have my balloon. Well. I'm gonna have to buy this, unfortunately. Is over here. And I get the feeling that's probably really close to the end of the level, too. Jump from the middle of things. You can't get anywhere near the edge because you fall right off or get set on fire or whatever. Whatever. I forgot I had a balloon. Shit. Well, that's a waste of that. Oh, back down the hole you go, Dip Gizmo. We're gonna try again. Anything in this game, I've noticed. You really need to cool your shit. Of a balloon, but whatever. Yeah, I think this will give me the edge that I need. Shit. I'm too old for this shit. No, those codes suck. There we go. Should have went here first. Let's see. So you mean to tell me, with all of these cheats that they have, they don't have one that just starts you with powered up weapons? I mean, there's like invincibility and shit, but I don't want invincibility. I want to try to actually, you know, do this shit on my own. Alright, let me try something here. Yeah, I know. I mean, I guess, yeah, if I'm gonna do that, I might as well just, you know, go all the way, but still. They have shit that's like view ending a bit into the intro of the first level. So you press start, and then after a few minutes, you immediately go to the ending, I guess. And they have this stupid cheat that says press start to display Japanese text. Why the hell would I want that? Let me keep looking. Same shit. Yeah, it's all the same shit. Alright, then fine. I guess we're doing it the hard way. Thank you. Thank you for the vote of confidence. Just hide here till the cyclones go away. There we go. See if I can do this without falling off the damn platform this time. Good. I wish I could have said that was done on purpose, but it wasn't. Come on, the shit. I mean, I made it, but that doesn't mean shit because, alright, you know what? Fuck it. I'm not doing that whole level again. I don't care. Alright, I'm done. I am done with this shit. The game is not going to be fair to me. I am not going to be fair to the game. And I know this is why people don't watch, but I don't care. It. Okay. Where is it? There it is. Don't mind me. Just doing some stuff. Don't mind the stuff that's being done. I don't care. All right, I am gonna turn it off though for this level. I do want to try to get through this level legit. Okay. Turn off. Thank you. Thank you. second. So now since we're powered up, we have exploding fire arrows. Although, I really wish we had the spread shot from before. This is going to be excruciatingly difficult. Especially when you get sniped like that. Okay, well, I'm on the last level at least. Oh yeah, this bow? Yeah, that's pretty awesome, huh? So it still explodes out, but it doesn't explode out in a circle. Do I get put? All the way back here. At least the enemies don't come back, though. That's a small consolation. I know, I'm close. Second, there we go. Remember earlier in the game when that fire-breathing guy was the biggest problem? Fine, fair enough, I guess. Come here. There we go. Oh, the music is getting screwed up. The music was getting messed up by everything that was going on. It's like the fire effects sounds are messing up with the music somehow. Keeps getting me every time. The hand keeps getting me all every time too. You don't want to jump? Jump button? Fine. We're starting over. Actually started me on this platform. Amazing.
Hmm.
gonna take another 5-minute break. I'll be right back. You do hear the music doing that weird shit, right? I'm not having auditory hallucinations, am I? Thank you. There's a door in this level. Now I'm doing stupid shit. Yeah, I don't know if there's a door on this level or not. I hope there is. Because that would really suck if there wasn't. Jump too soon, that part. It's starting to piss me off now. I'm safe stating. I don't care anymore. I have been browbeaten by this game for the last time. Extra life in tow. Let's keep it moving. Oh, so close. fine. Another one. I'm not using that extra life up that fast. No, sir. It is not happening, as the kids say. It's fine. I don't care, I made it. It's fine. That's right, I don't have the extra life anymore. No way in hell I'm doing that level over again. Take a little second here. Give myself a little break. Yeah, right? The completely black screen, the music, the fact that it basically just walks back and forth, side to side, and has like only one attack. Yeah, it's pretty much a Sunsoft boss. At least when it's a top-down Sunsoft game. We'll be right back. Boy, he sure likes to hog the screen, not the bottom. Come on. Damn it. That was just sloppy. That was just sloppy. God, he takes a lot of hits to kill. Keep doing that, man. That's great. I like your strategy. Alright, I'm done playing around. It's time to die. We'll be right back. get fucked. Thank you. Thank you for the GGs, even though I cheated. And then remember the movie ended. Sorry for the full screen flashing. So, if you didn't know how Gremlins 2 ended, basically, they made all of the evil gremlins gather in the center of the clamp building by making them think that it was nighttime. They doused them all with water, and then they released the electric gremlin out of the telephone and electrocuted all of them. And here's a bunch of people who hate children. Because, good lord, they did not need to design the game that difficult. End. Yay. Me too. Oh, it sticks us at a Sunsoft screen instead of just having us hang on the end. All right, well. That's gonna do it for tonight's Spooksgiving festivities. That was fun. That game is hard as balls. Yes, thank you all for watching. So, let's throw up our end screen. Thank you for clipping, viewing, watching, following, subscribing, all that shit. I really appreciate it. It, like I always say, it really means a lot to me that you guys like watching me screw up at video games for a few hours every now and then. If you're watching on YouTube, this is where we part ways, so have a good night.